Alright, welcome back to a playthrough of Super Mario RPG on the Super Nintendo by That One Gamer. So, we defeated the brainwashed Magikoopa, met Croco one more time to get the best armors in the game, and now we can finally continue on and get through to the end of the castle. Get to the sword. And here is the part where I was talking about the bullet bills. One enemy in the game that you just don't bite. Here it is, the bullet bills. And these are the ones that are vulnerable to the fright bomb. Oh wow, how about that? I was thinking someone else, because usually fright bombs do 100 like it did there. I know it's done 150 on certain enemies. Oh well. Sorry to hype you all up about that, because, like, let's do Bowser's Terrorize here in a minute. See, they are vulnerable to fear, but for some reason I thought we did 150. Ah! Alright, so level up here. Plus 3. Hey, that's less than 90 after all of that. You got plus 1 HP after that. Alright, so let's see here a minute. Oops, I'm gonna switch items. Quartz Charm, Ghost Metal, Safety Man. Well, I guess we'll keep it for now. There's a super big ass thwomp. And I got a fork here, don't worry about that. Yeah, Mr. Skitter. That's the cat's name. If you want to know what Mr. Skitters looks like, basically, you know what the cat looks like on those frisky cans? That's what he looks like. He looks exactly like that, and appropriately enough, he only likes Frisky's cat food. So that's what we get him. And no, I don't have any cat videos of any kind. I'm not one that posts videos or stuff like that. Plus, there hasn't been too much hilarity with the cat anyway. And let's see. Go back to the experience here. Let's get what the toads do. And bullet bills up there, you can actually see them flying in from the top of the screen there. So just wait a little bit and they'll come around. I thought there was an unlimited amount, but that must have been just Booty Tower that I was thinking. Mr. Skitter actually used to be a girlfriend's brother's cat, but he had to give him up after the landlord at some point found out that they had cats, so he had a cat. And my girlfriend didn't want to just lose the cat to someone or anything like that, and decided that we would adopt the cat. Plus, I like cats. I used to have a cat. My parents way back when, not way back then, but several years ago. And so, yeah, we were thinking about getting a cat anyway at some point. And it just pretty much all worked out. And, we're having a lot of good times, like just resting between us on the bed or at our feet. Got a little cat tree that actually gets up on. From my understanding, they said that Mr. Skitters here used to weigh like 35 pounds. He ate really a lot of food, but he's trimmed down a lot of weight. Now he's down to, last we weighed, about 18 pounds or so. Although when we originally got him, he was like down to 24 already. But in any event, time for the upcoming boss. I actually don't even want Bowser. So up here, you're actually going to fight two bosses, and for your little trick, have Geno in your party, and you can have anyone else that you want, but I'll make sure to have Gino. And let's see, who's gonna get what here? I would like to give her the safety ring. Let's see, get Quartz Charm here. Ghost Metal, yeah, I think that should do it. So, I think we're okay. Should I have the Lazy Shell or should I not? Nah, we'll be alright. So up here looks like a familiar looking room, but a little different. Ooh, who's that? Instead of Chain Chomps, it's Shy Guys that's holding up the chandeliers. Now we got this weird fish creature that's up here. And he jumps up there 100 feet in the air like that, but he can't do it in the game. Go figure. On guard! And she does have a sword. And the little dude's name is Boomer. Here's the trick to beating Boomer. When he is red color, use magic. And when it's blue, use physical attacks. And you'll take him down pretty quickly. You got 370. Oop! Man, I was way behind on that. Shaker, you want to be kind of early, and I was like way behind on the time there. It's one of those instant death attacks. Oops, wrong one. Super jump this dude. Skewer is one of those where you want to delay the timing because the character doesn't take damage until after he moves, Boomer moves back into his original position. Ah, I was way too early there. Yeesh, I can't win. Pretty soon he's gonna go to, blue, or maybe I'll just allow to feed him before he turns blue. Let's see what a fireball does to him. I don't know if he's vulnerable to fire or not. Not terribly. Ooh! I wanted to change colors. There we go. Have to do one more attack. When he changes color, he actually changes his attack strategy a little bit. So he uses magic as opposed to more physical strikes. So I basically use the opposite. Use magic when he uses physical. Use physical when he uses magic. Another benefit of the Quartz Charm, it is immune to instant death strikes. Except for the safety room does. Oh, there we go. We got the sad music again. Ooh, he's coughing. Suffered a mortal wound. Shows a little sympathy there, but and he slices chandelier hole there, forcing him to drop, and I guess that's how he wants to die. A little fall wouldn't hurt him, but a big ass fall would. And here's a little funny thing here. Chandelier Ho will take you to the top of the tower, atop of the keep, and it plays a more plays a fun music from Midas River, And they dance. Increasing speed. Here we go. Top floor. Fasten your seat. Go up there. Like I said, there are no seat belts. Love that part. However, before I continue on, I think I'm gonna stop here so the video doesn't get too long. You get to start out back at full health and full FP. And so I'm going to pause the video here, and then we'll see you all next time.